In this video, we will highlight the updates that have been made to the current generation of the ISOPOD. Safe transportation remains one of the most important components in caring for patients with highly infectious diseases. An ISOPOD is one device that can provide a safe environment during that time. Since recording our previous videos on the ISOPOD, there have been some significant updates to its design, although the basics of the unit remain unchanged. The first thing to note is that the ISOPOD is now manufactured by AirBoss Defense, who acquired the previous manufacturer in 2015. There are several models of the ISOPOD. In this video, we will be using the AirBoss Defense Advantage. To learn about the basic setup of the ISOPOD, you should refer to the ISOPOD Basics video on the HEROES website. There is one for the Immediate Response Technologies version and another for the model made by TVI. The two major updates included on the current AirBoss Defense ISOPOD are a pocket for a spine board and handles on each side of the device. First, let's take a look at the spine board pocket. The pocket is located on the bottom of the device with a pocket opening at the head end of the device. To place the spine board in the ISOPOD, open the Velcro flap and slide your spine board into the pocket. Once the spine board is in place, Velcro the flap back into place. The use of the spine board allows for better control during patient transfers. The other update to the ISOPOD is the addition of handles along the sides of the device. Three handles have been added on each side of the ISOPOD to allow for better control during patient transfers. Each handle is made from the same material as motor vehicle seat belts and is wrapped in a plastic tube to provide additional comfort while being held. With the addition of the new features, let's take a moment to consider the safety issues that you may encounter while operating the device. It is important to remember that a patient should not be placed on the long spine board for a long period of time. Prolonged time on the long spine board can initially cause discomfort for the patient and can eventually lead to skin breakdown. If a long spine board is not needed for immobilization purposes, the spine board can be removed during transfer to another facility. The handles should be used for controlling movement of the ISOPOD when transferring from gurneys to beds. It is not recommended that the handles be used for lifting and carrying the ISOPOD for extended periods if a patient is in the device. If the ISOPOD must be carried while a patient is inside, it is essential that a long spine board provides support at the base of the device and that each handle is operated by a separate person. This will provide the highest level of safety for the patient within the device and the environment through which it is being transported. An ISOPOD is a helpful tool when transferring a patient with a highly infectious disease. It is not something we use often, so it is important to practice with your ISOPOD to maintain competency.